Right, this particular wallet I'm painting there is going to be Frankenstein, or Frankenstein's monster. As you can see, I've cut out the brightest areas of the black and white image. This is my base stencil. Just let me map out the face and just give me the key areas to just position everything. I'll just keep cutting away at this stencil until there's not a great deal left of it, and then I'll just move on to the airbrush and the brushwork. I'm using ETAC paint for this project. Basically, I'm just going around just trying all sorts of different paints just to see how well they work out on the wallets. It's just a good size project to work on. So ETAC for this, and also mixed with the Liquitex slow dry blending medium, which I use on all everything anyway. So we'll just see how it turns out. It's funny, really, how easily you can actually see what this is just with the first rough cut stencil. Purely the major highlighted areas of the image I've cut out so far, and you can see that it's going to be Frankenstein just from that. So that's got to be a good thing. So what I'll do is I'll just keep cutting away a little bit more. We'll get a little bit more detail, and then it's just onto the airbrush and the brush. For this white, I've actually mixed 50-50. I've got the private stock chromatic white, which I think they now call transparent white, I think. And I've mixed it 1-to-1 ratio with the Polytac transparent binder. So whether I use that for the detail work later on, I'm not sure, but we'll see. But it's... this is how far I've got so far. Okay, I'm pretty pleased at this point. It's going along really well. I've cut out as much as I possibly can out of the bit of paper. There's nothing left of the paper. That's what's left of the paper. You just keep going. Some of the bits you find difficult to hold together, but it doesn't matter. It's just a guide at this stage. So that's I'm really pleased so far. So I'll just I'll carry on now, intensifying the highlights with the brush and the blending medium, and just giving it a little bit more detail, just with the white before I start with the black later on. Right, after I finished off with the transparent white, I moved on to the opaque plasma white, and so far, the face is all brushwork. The background I have slightly blended in under. And above the ears, I've blended in the brushwork with the airbrush. But apart from that, all this is brushwork so far, with the plasma white anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to intensify the forehead, the top of the head, and highlight the cheeks, etc., with the airbrush now, with the plasma white in it. I've diluted the plasma white not with water, but with the Polytac. I used to reduce my acrylics with water some time ago, but now I only use sort of a binder, really, if I can get away with that. So it just ensures maximum adhesion. So that's what I do. So I'm gonna fog this in now with the airbrush, and then I'll get back to you then. Well, I don't know if you can see a difference. I'm pretty sure you will be able to. I kind of rounded off all the larger areas of the highlights with the airbrush, and intensified the lighting on the top of the head, bridge of the nose and the eyelids, and around the chin as well, and I've also slightly intensified the background. So what I think now, I think the white's finished with pretty much for now. So I'll start with the black, and then I'll detail with the black and then do the shadowing, and maybe come back with some white for some small highlights at the end. So far this is just white. Right, so far this is opaque black mixed with the or some of it mixed with the blending medium, and put on with the brush. So there's no airbrushing on this just yet, the black anyway. So I'll intensify or blend out the shadows in the cheeks and under the eyebrow, and sort of round the head off. I'll do that with the airbrush now. I'm really pleased with the way the ETAC's going on with the blending medium. I get some really nice tight lines. Seems to sink into the leather really well as well. So I've got as much detail as I, as I can get really with a brush. I want to get that scarring around the cheek and sort of chisel out those really hard creases. I couldn't really do this with an airbrush, you know, you've got, that's what I really like about the brushing. And I think I'm going to, I'll perhaps intensify the white around the nostrils and the nose, bridge of the nose, and then the forehead as well. So I'll just play around, but for now I'm going to go back in with the black and the airbrush. Right, so far I've airbrushed what they call chromatic white, or is it's shading black. Chromatic black. It's shading black. It's transparent. So I've rounded the face off with these sort of overall shadows. I'm going to go in with some opaque black now and darken under the forehead there, and blend in that brushwork that I've done, and just think, see if there's any other areas that I want to intensify, and then I'll come back in with the some white highlights. Right, this is the opaque black that I've gone over some of the darkest areas with. I think actually in the video it's probably going to look a little bit darker than it actually is, but so I think now what I'm going to do is just refine some of the dark with a brush, and then go back in with some of the highlights, and I think that might be it. Right, I'm calling that a day now. I could keep going and put creases in and dots and scars and all sorts. So I think that's it. I finished off basically with some with the airbrush plasma white, just to even out some of the brushwork on the highlights. I'm very pleased with this one. So yeah, it's turned out great as far as I'm concerned anyway. I've dotted in even sort of little highlights. Anywhere I could see a highlight and I could get it with a brush, I've done my best to sort of bring out as much as I can, creases under the eyes, etc. So that's it really. Next thing, just to protect, well, not protect the artwork, I mean it wouldn't scratch off now anyway, but just to give it an even sheen, I'm just going to go over it with some Liquitex satin varnish, which is sprayable from the bottle, and I'll give it about 3 coats, and that's it. Right, so here's the finished article. Very pleased with it. It's got the coat of satin varnish on it. You can see the sheen on it. Just evens out all the paint work, because sometimes when you blend the paint with a blending medium, you get more of a sort of a gloss finish than you would, especially if you're just airbrushing. Airbrushing, you get quite a matte sheen on it. So it just levels all the sheen out. And as I said, it just sort of protects the artwork, and that's that. I'm not sure exactly how long this took me. Could have been the region of 5 hours, I think. Maybe a bit longer, but of course I've been videoing certain sections and photographing bits and pieces. So there you go. That's Frankenstein's monster on the leather wallet.